him a seagull. Or indeed a blue whale. A cow. About to be eaten by shark. Now, Budgie. I saw you in the pet shop by Budgie. And I know it sounds absurd, but the way you held the cage that held the bird, I knew right there and then I loved you. So I followed you back home, and I saw you lived all on your own. So when next you went out, I stood in your house and secreted a number of cameras. Minuscule things, so hard to see, are they inscrutable, these Japanese people? All of the cameras had microphones to catch every word that you uttered. I didn't put one in the bathroom though, I'm not a bloody nutter. I'm just a man who's found a woman to adore, and I'm going to be your stalker evermore. Later that evening, I saw you on my TV screen. You took off your hat and coat, and the scarf around your beautiful throat. You laid out a package upon the kitchen table, and from that you took a knife, and I've not seen as vicious a blade in my life. Till you opened the package again, and then you carefully took out another. If the first knife you had was the son of the family, then this one was surely the mother of all fish. Pointy at one end with two jagged edges and spikes coming out of the handle. That's when you took all your clothes off and lit up a ruddy grey candle. And your face took on a sudden mask of rage. And you turned around to face the Budgie cage. You rose to your feet with a knife in each hand and a torch in the twittering bird. You started to speak, but despite my equipment, I still couldn't make out a word you were on about. It started by Latin and later the cat in those 25 films that we knew. Then you did things to the Budgie that a cat would never do. And I watched. I watched. I don't want to be your stalker anymore.